In the first part of the video, we saw that when a force is applied on a body to rotate it, then one of the factors, the magnitude of the force matters, but another factor that matters is how far away from the axis you are applying the force. And we saw that a force applied further away from the axis is more effective in rotating it, which means the force which is applied further away has more torque, more turning effect. In this second part of the video, we will see the effect of angle at which the force is applied in applying the torque. Once again, to measure the force, I am using this spring balance, which is having two graduations, two scales. It is graduated in terms of Newton, it's graduated in terms of gram. So we can use the word gram weight, etc., gram force, etc. This is the body. And this time we'll be using just one point. First, I will apply a horizontal force to rotate it by some amount, which I will measure by the position of shadow on this mark. And then I will apply a force perpendicular to the rod. So let's apply a horizontal force first. And let's see how much is the, so the point has come here. The value is 1 Newton. When I'm applying a horizontal force, the value is 1 Newton. Now let's do it again. Same point, rotated by the same amount, but the force applied is perpendicular to the rod. Perpendicular to the rod. Now this time you see that the force applied is 0.8 Newton. A lesser force is required to rotate by the same amount, same body, same axis of rotation, rotated by the same amount, a smaller force is applied. So, which force is more effective in rotating this body? That effectiveness of force is called torque. And we see that the force which is applied perpendicular to the rod, that was more effective. A lesser force was required to rotate this rod by the same amount.